The shoulder girdle is made up of two bones, which are namely the clavicle and the scapula. And the scapula is also called the shoulder blade, and it articulates with the clavicle and the humerus. It is a flat bone that's found on the posterior chest wall, and it is triangular in shape. It stretches from the second rib to the seventh rib. It has got three borders, two surfaces, three processes, and three angles. So for the angles, we have got the superior angle, the inferior angle, and the lateral angle. If you don't really understand the terminology like inferior, superior, and lateral, please look at the link below so that you can watch the video on anatomical terms and positions. For the borders, we've got the superior border, the inferior border, and the medial border. Now it's time for us to look at the surfaces. The scapula has got two surfaces, which is the posterior surface and the anterior surface. And it has got three processes, which are the spinous process, which ends up being the acromion process. And on the other side, we've got the coracoid process. So the anterior surface of the scapula has got a huge depression, which we call a fossa. So in anatomy, when you hear the term fossa, it means a depression. So this fossa is called the subscapular fossa because it is found beneath the scapula, so called subscapular fossa. The posterior surface is divided into two parts by a spinous process. It divides it into the inferior upper part and the inferior part. The upper part is called the supraspinous fossa, and the lower part is called the infraspinous fossa. All these fossae are for attachment of muscles. We will later do the attachments of the muscles, but just to mention a few, we've got the muscles originating from the supraspinous fossa called the supraspinatus muscle, and that which originates on the infraspinous fossa is called the infraspinatus. On the lateral angle, we've got a fossa here called the glenoid fossa, and it articulates with the humerus to form the shoulder joint. There's a tubercle here, and simply because it's above the glenoid fossa, it's called the supraglenoid tubercle, and that below is called the infraglenoid tubercle. And these are also for the attachment of muscles. So in summary, we have learned that the scapula is a flat bone, which is triangular in shape. It has got two surfaces, three angles, three borders, and three processes. This is the superior border, the inferior border, the medial border. The processes, we've got the acromion process, the coracoid process, and the spinous process. For the tubercle, we've got the supraglenoid tubercle and the infraglenoid tubercle. And this is the glenoid fossa. Here's the anterior surface with the subscapular fossa for the subscapularis muscle. And here is the posterior surface with the supraspinous fossa for the supraspinatus and the infraspinous fossa for the infraspinatus. Please feel free to watch this video as many times as you can so that you can grasp each and every concept that we've discussed. If I was too fast for you, you can even reduce the speed on your settings on YouTube, so that you can grasp each and everything that we discussed. And if you find this video helpful, please subscribe to our channel and click the notifications button so that you can be notified when we upload a new video. As of now, enjoy your learning. See you soon.